Okay. So pupunta na tayo. I hope matapos tayo, no? Meron pa tayong almost an hour. So ito na po yung statistics in research. Okay. Diretso na po tayo, Ma'am Mika. So we have two areas, okay? The descriptive and the inferential. So when we're talking about descriptive statistics, it's analysis of data that helps describe, show, or summarize data in a meaningful way, such that, for example, patterns might emerge from a data. Okay? But descriptive statistics is limited. Now the question is, kapag descriptive ba ang statistics na ginamit ko sa aking research, does that mean that my research is a low, medyo mababang klase? Low class, low type of research? Not really. Tama yan, no? Just because you use bar graph, pie chart, puro mga ganun lang ginamit mo, bar chart, pie chart, mean, median, does it mean that your research is a low class or not the best or walang chance para maging best thesis. Okay? Saan ba natin binibase yung mga statistics natin? It depends on the objective of your research. Okay? Baka mamaya ang objective mo lang naman is to describe your sample. Tapos ikaw ay nag-t-test, ikaw ay nag-Kramer's V, ikaw ay nag-Pearson. So, hindi ka pa ngayon ma-elect for best research kasi mali yung ginamit mong statistics. Understood? But the limitation of the descriptive research is it's that it's limited in so much that they only allow you to make summations about the people or objects that you have actually measured. Okay? You're not inferring, basically. Kaya si inferential statistics, it is called inferential because you're inferring from a sample to a population. Yes, that's correct. From sample going to the population. Next slide po. Inferential statistics now includes all the techniques used in analyzing the sample data that will lead to generalizations about a population from which the sample came. Now, if you would want to extend what you collected and what you have analyzed to a larger, no, population, then what you will be doing is an inferential statistics. Pero, maaari mo lang itong gawin. You can only do these things if, number one, well, if you have met the requirements for an inferential statistics. Okay? The limitations, data about a population not fully measured. Of course, because you're just inferring. No? For example, 91% satisfaction rating from the 1,200. Kunwari, let's say for argument's sake, for discussion purposes, na the 1,200 is enough to infer to a 15 million population or a 16 million population. We're not really sure that that 91% is actually 91%. No? Maaring it's 89.8, maybe it's 92.1, maybe it's 91.7. We don't know. Okay? We don't know for sure. Okay? But what we have generated is actually very near the true value. That is the goal of inferential statistics, to conclude or to create generalizations from a sample to a population, where in this particular sample is actually very near the true value of the population. Okay? Second limitation, educated guesses are required to fully run the inferential test. What is this educated guess again? How do we call it? It starts with an H. It's, ayan, hypothesis. Okay? Oo. Yung iba kong mga student, minsan nasasagot nila, hypothalamus po, sir. Okay? Wag yun. Iba yun, ha? Hypothesis. All right. So now, let's go to the next slide, ma'am. Okay. So this is a graph, no, of population to a sample. So the population is a large group, and then you will randomly pick. Kasi nga, we do randomization techniques. No? So we draw a sample from a population, and then from the sample, we try to infer to form a generalization, given that you have satisfied the requirements for hypothesis testing. Aalamin natin yung mga requirements mamaya. Okay? So the sample now, so the descriptive stat now just describes the sample. Okay? And if you want to extend the observation towards a population, then you are doing an inferential statistics. Okay? My conclusion, kapag inferential, stat. Okay? I think wag na tayong mag-test ng understanding para matapos natin at makapag-demo ako ng software. Kahit isa or dalawa lang. Para makita nyo lang outlier test, tapos siguro kahit isang Pearson, isang t-test, no? Sige. Now, here are some basic statistical methods in quantitative research. Okay, for descriptive, we have five. We have four. Tapos dalawa dyan yung pinakasikat, no? The measures of central tendency and the measures of dispersion. Hindi natin i-discuss yung measures of position and shape kasi wala na tayong oras. Okay. So like what I said kanina, tatlo ang measure of central tendency. Average lahat yan. Mean, median, and mode. Okay? And then the measure of dispersion, we have the variance, standard deviation, and then coefficient of variation. Kailan hindi pwedeng gamitin ang mean? Kapag meron kang tinatawag nating outlier. Okay? For the spelling, can someone please type outlier? Pinagahang ng aking laptop. Ayan. Ang bagal niya. Ayan. Outlier. Okay? Kapag may outlier ka, the mean is affected. Okay? So that's why the first thing that you have to do, once you have collected your data, once you have collected all of the observations, the first thing that you have to do is to do an outlier test or a normality test. Kapag may outlier, wag kang mag-mean. Or, yun yung first option mo. Or, tanggalin mo yung outlier. Pwede ba yun? Pwede ba tanggalin? Hala sir, pwede tanggalin nyo yun? What do you think? Yes or no? Yes. Pwede magtanggal. Tinatawag natin yan sa methodology na data cleaning. Kagaya na sabi ko, yung methodology ay hindi part ng aking lecture, no? Maybe if Ma'am Mika will invite me again, I can discuss, no? Methodology, samplings, research subject, research design, and so on. So, pwede siyang tanggalin. Kung gusto mo talagang mag, ano, hypothesis testing. Kasi if you have outliers, you cannot do hypothesis testing. Especially kung nag-exceed ka na doon sa iyong level of significance na pag-aaralan natin mamaya. Okay? So, kung hindi pwede na si mean, sino nang gagamitin mo ngayon? Si median na. And if it's qualitative or counts, it's the mode. Okay? For the measure of dispersion, we have the variance, standard deviation, and coefficient of variation. Okay? Note, these descriptive statistics are appropriate for quantitative variables. Pwede ba yung mode? Sir, pwede ba yung mode sa quantitative variables? Eh, ang example mo kanina, color. Pero pwede pa rin ba siya sa quantitative? Kunwari, 5 students. Ang scores nila ay 15, 15, 15, 49, 50. Should I use mean or median there? No. Ang gagamitin ko doon ay mode. Pwede rin sigurong median for interquartile range. Ganun, no? Alright. Let's go to the next one. For categorical now, we'll be using frequency, percentage, category proportion, and cross-tabulation. Yan, si mode, bumabagsak din siya doon sa frequency, kasi counts. So, si mode, ano siya? Pwede siya sa descriptive, sa categorical, pwede rin siya sa quantitative. Okay? Sige. Now, the summary of descriptive statistics is presented in this table. Mabilisan ko lang. Let's go to the next slide po, ma'am. Yan. Kapag qualitative siya, maaaring nominal or categorical, we're disregarding the distribution. Hindi hilingan ang distribution. Always remember that. If our data is nominal or ordinal, let's not look into this into the distribution anymore. Okay? So, kapag nominal, ang gagamitin mo for central tendency and dispersion is mode, frequency, percentage, proportion, or counts. Okay? Kapag ordinal naman, median. Ayan. And then, for dispersion, ordinal, you use interquartile range. Okay. For quantitative now, if the distribution is not normal, kailan ulit hindi nagiging normal ang distribution? If there are outliers. Kapag may outliers ka, do not use mean. What you will be using is the median. Okay? So range ang ginagamit dyan for the dispersion. And if your data is flawless, tinatawag namin siya sa stat na flawless, ibig sabihin normal yung distribution, tapos numerical pa siya, okay? You'll be using mean for the central tendency and standard deviation for the dispersion. Okay? Okay. So, for the descriptive, ayan, charts and graphs yung ginagamit natin to describe descriptive stats. Pero, sometimes, or most of the time, na-abuse natin si pie chart. Tama ba? Kunwari, may inano na bilang ng umiinom ng Coke, Sprite, Royal, Pepsi, root beer, pinapie chart. Okay? Hindi dapat, no? May appropriate yan na gamit. Okay. Kailan ginagamit si line chart? Ginagamit si line chart for trends. For example, ako as a working person, gusto kong malaman yung pagbabago ng aking salary, no? Sa pagdaan ng panahon. Then I can use line chart. Yan sa stocks. Okay? Sa stocks, pwede yan. How is the stocks growing over time? Yan. How is your plant growing over time? You can use line chart for that. How about bar chart? When is bar chart used? Bar chart is used for magnitude. Pag binibilang. And for comparison naman is multiple bar chart. Hindi ko na nilagay. Yung mga basic lang kasi yung nilagay ko dito. Weather condition. Can we represent it using charts? Kapag overtime, pwede naman siguro. Tapos yung weather condition, and as long as your weather condition is defined for the Y. But I don't think so. Dapat kasi connected. So hindi pwede yung line chart doon. Dapat kasi connectado siya. Okay? So si pie chart, ano naman ang, ano, silbi ni pie chart? It's part of the whole. Okay? For example, male and female, yan pwede yung pie chart, pwede rin bar. Depende kung paano mo tinreat. Tinitreat mo ba yung male and female as part of one sample or one population? If you're treating it as part of one sample or one population, then you can use pie chart. If you're treating it as magnitude, then you can use bar. And then, ano yung nasa pinakalast? Yung nasa ilalim ng bar chart, anong tawag dyan? It's called a scatter plot. Yeah. So, census versus survey, no? Kapag, when you're taking the entire population into consideration, no, of taking the observations from them, then what you are doing is a census. Kaya ang tawag po ng National Statistics Office or the Philippine Statistics Authority is census when they are getting data from the entire population of the Philippines. Okay? That's why it's called a census. Kasi buong populasyon ng Pilipinas. Election is not really a census because there are people who do not participate. And number two, there are people who are not qualified to vote. Right? But if your population under study are the voters, then yes. Okay? But if your population under study is the population, the Filipino people, then hindi. So as you can see, that's why I was telling you earlier, di ba? Your population under study should be defined. Am I clear with that? Okay? Ah, sige. So dapat ganon, no? So kapag survey, then sample lamang ang kinukuha. Okay? That's why mas sikat si survey kesa kay census. Meron nga nagle-lecture ako sa mga college na ito, ha? This is a lecture. And then when I asked them about census, ang alam nila, yung kinakandak ni National Statistics Office every October of the year. Every 3 years yata yun. Yun yung alam nila na census. Well, it's actually a census. But census in general is taking observation from the entire population. Okay? Second requirement is your randomization technique. So, dapat what you will be using is probability sampling. Oh, ano yung mga example ng probability sampling? Magbibigay ako ng isa, yung pinakasikat. Random sampling. Yan. When you use random sampling, it's a probability sampling. The stratified sampling. Okay? Ano pagkakaiba ni stratified at saka ni random? Si random, random lang. Kuha ka lang ng kuha. Pero kapag stratified, meron siyang naturally occurring groups that we call strata. Kagaya ng mga sections sa grade 12. Let's say for example, yung mga sections sa grade 12, that is called a strata. Then you can randomly pick from these sections. Pwedeng equal, number, or proportional. Okay? Hindi pwedeng unequal dahil lang unequal. Dahil gusto mo lang unequal. Dapat it's either equal or proportional. Okay? So that's stratified sampling. Ano? The fishbowl method is, walang strata kasi. There is no strata in a fishbowl method. Right? I'm not so particular with the fishbowl because it's qualitative. Ma'am Mika, can you confirm what I am saying? There is no strata. There is no naturally occurring group for a fishbowl method. Tama po ba yun, Ma'am Mika? Unlike in a stratified sampling, there is a naturally occurring group, like your section. Your section is a naturally occurring group. And then in fishbowl, sometimes it's a random. Correct? Pag fishbowl, kumari, o kayong lima na nandiyan sa harap, fishbowl nyo. Right? Okay. So one is random. Second is stratified. Ano pa? We have the cluster sampling. Okay? We also have the systematic sampling. Now, normally, yes, correct, Carlos Joseph. Systematic. Normally, the easiest one to use sa lahat ng probability sampling is the systematic sampling. Okay? Because in all of this probability sampling, number one is you should have a list of all the members of the population. Okay? Then kapag systematic, you decide on which to start. Tapos, kumare, yung pangpito, every seventh member, yun yung pipiliin mo. So if you start with number 3, then number 10, then number 17, then number 24, paano po namin masasatisfy? Yun yung normal na tanong sa akin, no, for systematic. Paano po namin masasatisfy or when should we stop picking? Kapag satisfy mo na yung sample size, which is the next one. Okay? So the sample size, yan, very important. Kagaya nga ng sabi ko kanina, no, yung 30 is just a test for normality. Pero yung sample size mo, yan ay requirement for you to do hypothesis testing and inferential statistics. Okay. Ano yung ginagamit? Sabi ko kanina, at least be interval. Okay? And number 3, the variance is the same. Okay? Yung number 3, normally hindi naman siya masyadong pinagtutuunan ng pansin. Am I being choppy again? Am I getting choppy again? Hindi naman. Okay pa rin. Okay. Sige. So, basta, at least your level of measurement is interval and your distribution is normal. Sige. And then, the level of significance. Okay. This time, we have three level of significance. Ano yung tatlong level of significance? From your statistics lesson. Ibigay ko yung isa. 0.01. Kulang ka lang ng percent, Rafael. Tama yan. 96.5? The 0.01, the 0.05, the 95%, correct? And the 0.1, or the 90%. So, tatlo yan, no? The, correct, the 0.90, 0.95, and the 0.99 level of significance. Okay? So, normally, ang ginagamit for experimental is 0.99. Kasi maliit lang naman talaga yung errors dyan. Kasi ang magkaka-error lang dyan, either it's a human error or it's a machine error. Especially if the experimental research is done in the laboratory. Yung mga machine ay kinakalibrate. Okay? So, sa social science, pwede yung 95 or 90. No, kasi marami talagang error, no? So pwedeng 95. 95 is a good fit. Kasi pag 99, very strict. Pag 90 naman, masyado na kayong maluwag. Masyado na maraming error yung tinatanggap nyo. Okay? And then lastly is the decision rule for the value of P. Okay? Ngayon, P value na po ang kinukuha. Kung hindi ako nagkakamali, kung kayo ay nag-aral ng stat, tapos meron kayong t-test or ANOVA, meron kayo nung may Z kayo, no? May Z-test kayo. Wag muna po yan, Ma'am Nika. Mahihilo po sila. Ayan. Meron kayong Z, di ba? Tapos meron kayong table. Correct? May table of critical values kayo. Oo. Nung wala pang mga softwares, ginagamit yung critical values. Pero now, na meron ng mga software, P-value na yung ginagamit. Probability value. Okay? So, ang decision rule natin sa value of P, kapag mas mataas yung value of P kesa dun sa level of significance alpha mo, what do? You fail to reject the null hypothesis. If P is greater than alpha, you fail to reject. But if P is less than alpha, reject. Okay? Did you get that? Malalaman natin yan mamaya. Saan po makukuha yung p-value? So sabi natin, no, if p-value is less than or equal to the alpha, then the null hypothesis is rejected. Saan natin makukuha yung p-value? Gine-generate din yan ni software. Makikita natin yan mamaya. Okay? Okay, so yun yung steps for hypothesis testing. Dapat meron kang hypothesis, you satisfy the parametric assumptions, you know the level of significance, and you know the decision rule for the value of P. Are we okay so far? Any questions so far? Ayan, sige. Let's continue. Ma'am Nix, Ma'am Nika, skip na natin yung yan. Oo. Kasi may explain ko naman siya dun sa table. Malapit na tayo matapos, may papakita ko na yung software sa inyo. Sige na tayo sa table. Ayan. So this is a summary of commonly used statistical methods. Yung mga naka-red, excuse me, yan yung mga madalas na ginagamit, no? According lang yan sa akin, according lang yan sa aking experience, doing statistics for thesis, for graduate thesis. So, ito yung mga madalas na ginagamit. Pero hindi ko naman sinasabi na ito yung gamitin nyo. Okay? And all of these are just examples. No? Marami pang mga tests for that. Okay? Pero ito kasi normally na ginagamit. Okay. Now, this one is appropriate only if you are comparing or if you are testing the differences. Kapag ang tanong mo sa research question mo ay, is there a significant difference between this and that? Ito ang mga gagamitin mo. Okay? Ngayon, dapat masatisfy mo yung normality. Okay? Dapat meron ka ring hypothesis. Ah, balikan muna natin hypothesis. Hindi ko na-discuss. Ano yung dalawang klase ng hypothesis? What are the two types of hypothesis? We have the null hypothesis, that's correct. And then the alternative, yes. Okay? The null hypothesis says that walang significant difference, walang significant relationship, walang impact, walang influence. No? Yan ang sinasabi ni null hypothesis. And that is what we are presenting in a quantitative research. Ano naman si alternative hypothesis? The alternative hypothesis is also what you call the researcher's hypothesis. Because we are praying, if we are doing a research, we are praying that somehow merong relationship, merong difference, merong impact, merong influence. Okay? Pero bakit null hypothesis yung pinapresent natin? Kasi mas madaling mag-disprove kesa mag-prove. Okay, did you get that? Kasi if I'm trying to prove something, kailangan ko pang mag-collecta ng napakaraming evidence para masabi mo na merong significant difference, merong relationship, merong influence. Okay? So, ang pinapresent mo ngayon, null. Kasi mas madaling sabihin na, ah, wala. Wala, kasi wala eh. Right? Yun lang yung ano nun. Yun yung, that is the basic concept. Why we present the null hypothesis instead of the researcher's hypothesis or the alternative hypothesis. But of course, we're always praying na somehow, sana meron. Okay? Now, our groups can be related or independent. Dapat alam natin yon. Okay? Kailan nagiging related at kailan nagiging independent yung group. Okay, makinig. Kapag related ang group, ibig sabihin, may dalawang material na ginamit. Pero the group is just a single one. Okay? O kaya, groups with the same characteristics. Okay? Kunwari, merong kayong, I don't know if this is being done in CIIT, pero, what is that, the test before you take the lessons? Anong tawag doon? Anong tawag doon yung sa binibigay mong test bago mag-lesson? Pre-test, oh, pre-test siya, pero may tawag eh. Diagnostic test, yan. Yan, diagnostic test. Okay. Tapos, yung diagnostic test na yon, iti-take mo ulit after mo ng lesson. Okay? So, dahil iisa lang yung material, or dalawa yung material mo, isang diagnostic test, tsaka isang summative test, tapos iisa lang yung group, then that is called, in statistics, related. Okay? Or, mga grupo, dalawang magkaibang grupo, pero pareho yung mga properties nila. Okay? Ano yon? For example, this section and another section. Pareho silang honors section. Okay? Hindi heterogeneous, no? Homogeneous yung sections. Parehong honors. So, ibig sabihin, they are related groups. They are comparable na tinatawag. Okay? The second type of group are the independent groups. Ito naman yung mga grupo na hindi talaga magkakonekta. Dalawa yung groups, no? Na magkakonekta. Okay? And then we have to know the level of measurement. Okay? We have the qualitative nominal, the qualitative ordinal, and the quantitative. Okay? Okay. Sige. Kapag related yung group mo at nominal, you will be using the McNemar test. And normally naman, hindi tinetest yung difference ng nominal. Okay? So, hindi masyadong ginagamit sa si McNemar test. Okay. You will be using the Wilcoxon rank sums test if it's related and ordinal. Okay? Kapag ordinal na yung iyong data, you'll be using the Wilcoxon rank sums test. But if it's quantitative, you'll be using the t-test for correlated sample. Or in the softwares, ang tawag sa kanya ay paired t-test. Paired. Yan. Yan ang tawag sa t-test for correlated sample. Pag independent naman, you'll be using Fisher test for nominal, Mann-Whitney-U test for ordinal, and the t-test for uncorrelated sample in the interval. Okay? Ang tawag dyan sa software ay two groups t-test. Okay? Pag related naman at more than two yung grupo mo, and it's qualitative, you'll be using the Cochrane Q-test. Magkaiba po ito, this is different from the Cochrane's test for determining the number of sample. Okay? Kasi si Cochrane, sikat yan sa world of statistics. And then, if it's ordinal, you'll be using the Friedman. And if it's quantitative, then you'll be using the repeated measures of ANOVA. Kapag related. Pero kapag independent, ANOVA lang. Either one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, and so on. Pero kapag nominal siya, tapos difference, you'll be using chi-square test. And it's Kruskal-Wallis kapag ordinal. Magulo? Malinaw ba magulo? CIIT students? Is that okay? Kasi ito yung qualifications. Na for example, ang aking grupo ay dalawa. Tapos related sila. Tapos yung kinolekta kong data ay quantitative. So, t-test for correlated samples ang gagamitin ko. Okay lang to? Yan. Mukhang matatalino ang mga students po ninyo, Ma'am Mika. Very good po. Okay. So, ito kasi medyo masalimuot. No? Medyo complex. No? So, let's go to the next slide. Ito, madali na to, no, for association. Kasi normally, no, the quantitative research in senior high school has two goals. Ano? The goal for the quantitative research in senior high school is to investigate and explore bivariate analysis. Pag sinabing bivariate, ibig sabihin dalawa lang ang variable na i-analyze mo. Isang dependent tsaka isang independent. Kasi it's just an introduction lang naman to quantitative. Okay? Okay. Now, the test for association. Ito, dalawang pinag-aaralan normally for bivariate analysis. Either it's relationship or it's differences. No, yan yung nakalagay sa ating curriculum guide na binigay ni DepEd. So, yung kanina na pinresent ko sa inyo, those are tests for differences or comparison. Ito naman po ngayon, these are tests for association or relationship. Kapag nominal, chi-square. Chi-square-based measures like Kramer's V. Okay? Kapag ordinal, the Spearman's Rho or the Spearman's rank test. And pag interval and ratio, we'll be using the Pearson correlation coefficient or the Pearson's R. Okay. Wala kayong tanong? Ako magtatanong pag wala kayong tanong. That's always the case in my classes. If you do not have questions, I'll be the one to ask you questions. O ganito. For example, may face-to-face learning pa rin. Hopefully, gusto niyo na bang mag face-to-face classes? Say IT. Yes, no, right? Ah, ayaw ng iba. Ah, ganun no, maganda tong pag-aaral. Yung iba ayaw ng face to face. Mas okay na sila sa bahay sila at the comforts of their home, no, eating while listening, no. Some naman gustong-gusto nang makita yung mga friends and so on and so forth. Okay? Anyway, sige. Let's say for example, may face to face na classes right now. Tapos, ang inalam mo ay expenditure. That's your first variable. Expenditure. Or you miss the air conditioning, no? Oo, ganyan din yung mga students namin sa TIP. They miss the air conditioning. Okay. So anyway. Okay. So for example, nagkaroon ng face-to-face class, no? And then, your research is about expenditures of a student. And relationship, kung may relationship ba yung dami ng gastos mo sa academic performance mo. Okay. Because they say that expenditures and income is quite a sensitive issue, gagawin mo siyang bracket. Magkano ang nagagastos mo average in a day? For example, ilalagay mo zero. Pwede bang zero? Pwede, may ganun ba? May ganun kaya? Anyway, zero to 200. 201 to 400. 401 to 600 and so on. Ano yon? Anong klaseng variable yon? Is it qualitative or quantitative? Expenditure. Pero naka-bracket. Is it qualitative or quantitative? Tandaan na, it's expenditure, money. Pero naka-bracket. Is it qualitative or quantitative? Kasi for example, ang tanong mo, magkano ang nagagastos mo sa isang araw? How much do you spend in a day? That's 0 to 100, 101 to 200, 201 to 300. So is it qualitative or quantitative? Basically, it's qualitative because we cannot perform operation based on their answer. Tama ba? Nabalikan ba yung discussion natin kaninang mga 130, 145? Yes. We cannot perform operation on the 0 to 100 and 101 to. Hindi siya pwedeng i-add. Diba? Okay. So basically, magiging ordinal yan. Na ang pinakamababa ay yung 0 to 100, tapos next is 101 to 200, and so on. Okay? Quantitative, ordinal. Pwedeng ganon. Quantitative, pero ordinal. Okay? Pero pag ordinal kasi, qualitative siya. Diba? Alright. So, qualitative na yung isa, yung expenditure. Tapos yung academic performance. Ano yung academic performance? Is it qualitative or quantitative? Pag academic performance kasi, normally grade. Is it qualitative or quantitative? Yung grade mo sa card, yun yung academic performance normally. So, it's quantitative, right? Okay. So, meron ka nga yung isang quantitative. Anong quantitative yung grade sa card? Interval or ratio? Interval. Yan. So, meron ka nga yung interval at saka ordinal. Tama? Yung interval natin ay yung academic performance. Tapos, yung ordinal natin ay yung binracket nating expenditure. Okay, the question here is, anong gagamitin kong test of association? Is it Spearman or Pearson? Kasi magkaiba sila ng level of measurement. Paano yun? Paano po yun, sir? Ano nga po pala talaga ang gagamitin namin dyan? Is it Pearson or Spearman? Kasi hindi ka naman pwedeng mag-Kramer's V kasi wala ka namang nominal. So what do you think? Hula lang. Di ba sabi natin kanina, hierarchical siya? Ano ibig sabihin ng hierarchy? Ibig sabihin, yung mga quality ni nominal, ordinal, interval ay pwedeng meron kay ratio. Yung quality ni nominal at ordinal, pwedeng meron kay interval. Yung quality ni nominal, meron din kay ordinal. So, pwede bang bumaba si interval kay ordinal? Pwede ba akong bumaba? Kumari ako kay interval level. Pwede ba akong bumaba sa ordinal level? Pwede bang nakarank yung academic performance? Yun yung question doon. Pwede bang nakarank yung 96 mas mataas sa 95? Yung 95 mas mataas sa 81? Pwede, right? Ibig sabihin yung characteristic ni interval, ay ni ordinal, meron kay interval. Correct. So ano ngayon ang dapat kong gamitin? Correct yourselves kung mali yung naisagot nyo kanina. That's okay. Tandaan na, okay lang na makorrect mo ang sarili mo as long as you are able to correct it in a correct and a nice way. Ayan. So, Spearman ang gagamitin nyo kasi ordinal yung lowest level of measurement mo. Okay po yun? So, ganun po ang pagpili ng statistical methods. Okay? Alright, so let's try some exercises. Ma'am Nika, isa-isa po ah. Yan, sige. Number one, this is the null hypothesis. There is no association between gender and soft drink preference. Ano yung ating data na kinokolekta dito? Gender tsaka soft drink preference. Anong level of measurement nila? Gender, soft drink preference. They are both nominal. Okay. Ngayon, ano yung tinetest natin? Is it association, relationship, or difference? Relationship ba or difference? Association or relationship. Okay. So, ibig sabihin ng pwede lang natin piliin yung chi-square based measures, Spearman or Pearson. Pwede naman may mga iba pa, no? Pero yun yung medyo mga sikat. Okay. So, ano ngayon yung gagamitin natin? Is it the chi-square based? Is it the Spearman? Or is it the Pearson? Pakiclick nga po. Let's check the answer. So, dapat ang statistical test natin ay... Can you click again, ma'am? Yan. The chi-square based measures. Napakadami po niyang chi-square based measures na yan. Pero ang isa sa mga sikat dyan is the Kramer's V. Okay? Let's go to the next slide. Tingnan natin. Ayan, yan muna. There is no significant difference between the satisfaction level of four-piece and non-four-piece member to the government response during this pandemic. Okay. So sabi, wala daw pagkakaiba yung satisfaction level ng four-piece and non-four-piece member. So ang tinetest natin dito is, ma'am, can we, ay, wag muna ma'am. Ang tinetest natin dito is related or independent groups. Related ba ang four-piece member tsaka non-four-piece member or are they independent? What do you think? Ayan. They are independent. Okay? Independent sila. Tapos satisfaction level. Anong level of measurement yan? Anong level of measurement yung satisfaction? Ordinal. Number two. Correct. Ayan. May natutunan sa akin ang mga CIIT students. Ilang grupo meron? Meron dalawang grupo. So, ano ang ating test na gagamitin? We will be using the Mann-Whitney-U test. Sige, ma'am, pa-next na po. We will be using the Mann-Whitney-U test. Ma'am, can we go back to slide number 39? Yung ano po, yung table ng summary ng statistical methods for comparison. Para makita po nila na dalawa yung grupo, independent, tas nominal. Yes, they are independent. Tama po. Slide number 39 sa akin po. Yung ano po ma'am, summary po ng statistical methods for comparison. Hindi ma'am, sa baba pa po. Number 39 po. Slide 39. Yan po ma'am. Ayan. So as you can see, independent groups, diba? Tapos dalawa. Tinan nyo sa left. I hope you're looking at it. Independent groups, dalawa. Correct? Tapos ordinal. Saan ka bumagsak? Sa Mann-Whitney U test. Okay? Did you get the idea of determining your statistical test? Ayan. Buti naman. So yun lang yung kailangan ninyo para malaman ninyo yung statistical test. How to identify the appropriate statistical test. Tapos, software niya ang gagamitin ninyo. Si software niya ang bahala. Basta dapat lang appropriate. Okay? So, let me share with you how to use the software that I am using, which is the Minitab software. Can I be the one to present? Okay. Paano mag-present? Hindi po kasi ako familiar sa Google Meet. We are using the big blue button for our big blue button din po kayo, ma'am. Oh, I see. Ah, yes. Apo, nakita ko na po. Kaso, hindi ko ma-share yung aking application. Bakit ganun? Hindi ko ma-share si Minitab. Pwede bang may entire screen na lang? Hindi, okay lang. Ayan, naka-share na ba? Hindi pa. Ah, ayun, kiniklik pala. Sorry. Ayan. So, kailangan may magsagot sa akin na magsasalita, no? Can you see the Minitab screen? Dahil hindi ko po makikita yung sagot ninyo. So, someone has to talk.
Yes, po.
Kita po ang Minitab screen. Ayan. So, this is the Minitab software. Okay? As you can see, sa bottom, meron tayong parang worksheet, no? Parang worksheet that you can see in an Excel. And this is where we input the values, no? What's good in Minitab is that it accepts words. Kagaya niya, may nakalagay dito, no? Ang variables ko dito is as you can see, C1 sa column ng inyong cell, then that means it's a word, it's a descriptive data. Okay? Then C2 is the tuition. Next is the periodical test score. Yes.
Sir, nawawala-wala po kayo.
Really? How about now? Can you hear me well?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean nawawala-wala? Yung audio ko ba ang nawawala-wala?
Yes, sir. Medyo naglalag ka.
Bakit ganun? Wait po. How about now? Okay na po. Sige. Nakikita pa rin po yung Minitab screen?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay, yes. Sige. So, like what I said kanina, no, may worksheet sa ilalim, no? This is where you input the data. Okay, yung mga observations na kinalekta nyo, dito siya. So, meron akong apat na variable dito. Okay? Number one is the category of the school, whether it's public or private. Number two is the tuition. Number three is the periodical test score. And number three is the achievement test score. Okay. Ano yung public and private? So someone has to talk. Anong klaseng ano yan? Anong klaseng level of measurement? Public, private.
Nominal.
It's nominal, no?
Nominal,
yes, that's correct. That's nominal. Dichotomous. No? Then the tuition, periodical test score, and achievement test score, they are all quantitative. Kasi wala naman tayong problema sa quantitative, like what I said. No? Ah, bumagal na ang aking internet speed. Anyway, now, we will be performing several tests. Siguro magpa-perform ako ng mga tatlo or apat na test para makita nyo kung paano. No? Yung mga medyo sikat lang. Okay. First, anong una kong dapat gawin bago ako mag-perform ng mga statistical test? Anyone?
The objective?
Yes, we have to know the objectives of my study. Pero ano kailangan kong gawin muna sa data ko? Alamin ko kung meron o walang starts with an O. Walang oh my God.
Outlier.
Outlier, ayan. So, either we'll be doing a normality test or an outlier test. So, as you can see here, no, my stat, you will be clicking stat, and then basic statistics, then you will be performing an outlier test. Para malaman natin kung may mga outliers. As you can see, ang makikita nyo dito sa left is just the tuition, periodical test, and achievement test score. Kasi, wala namang outliers for nominal. Okay? So, tingnan natin kumari sa periodical test score. I just have to double-click. Okay? Tapos yung graph ko, outlier plot. Options. As you can see, I'm using the Grubbs outlier test. Marami kasi yan. Pwedeng Dixon's, Dixon's Q, R11, and so on and so forth. Pero normally, ang ginagamit kasi ay Grubbs outlier test. And as you can see, the significance level is 0.05. Yan po ang default significance level for all, I think all, statistical softwares. Okay. So, yan yun. And then I just have to press OK. So, bibigyan ako ni Minitab ng outlier plot. Pero dito sa taas ng worksheet, nasabihin niya sa iyo kung meron o wala. So as you can see here, sabi ni Minitab, there is no outlier at the 5% level of significance. What is the implication of this? Kung walang outlier. Ha? Anong implication niya? Ibig sabihin, I can perform hypothesis testing for the data periodical test score. Pwede ako dyan mag-t-test, pwede ako mag-Pearson, and so on and so forth. Kasi quantitative naman siya. Okay? Depende sa objective ng aking research. Okay. Ngayon, mag-outlier test naman ako for periodical test. Outlier test. Ah, periodical pa rin ang pinuha ko kanina, no? Achievement test naman. Okay? So, this is the outlier plot. And then, as you can see, nilagay din niya walang outlier at 5% level of significance. So, ibig sabihin, pwede rin ako mag-hypothesis testing for my achievement test score. Okay. For example, ang aking population under study ay students in Marikina. Let's say, for example. Ngayon, aalamin ko ngayon kung may pagkakaiba, if there is a difference between the periodical test score and the achievement test score. Okay. Ngayon, public and private yan. Pero is my population under one, ano lang, under one vicinity? Ang population ko defined, for example, students in Marikina City. Ganyan. O, kapag students in Marikina, ano yon? Related? Related ba? Or isang group lang ba ito? Isang group lang ba ito? Or meron ba akong dalawang grupo? Gitropo ko ba sila as private and public? Or tinreat ko sila yung data, ha? I'm talking about the data. Or tinreat ko sila as one lang, as one collection. Di ba one collection lang? So meron lang ako isang grupo, tapos may dalawa akong variable. So that is, hindi siya kasama, no? Pero that is a one sample t-test. Okay? So one sample t-test yan na ginagamit. Okay? So meron kang periodical test and achievement, perform hypothesis test, the hypothesis size mean is 0.95. And the graphs that I will be generating is a histogram, and the confidence level is 95. And then, para lang makita nyo yung ano, no, p-value and so on. Yan. Okay. So, yung p-value, as you can see, andito siya. Okay? Ay, sorry, na-highlight lahat. Yung nasa pinakadulo, ito yung p-value. Nakikita po?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, class, if you will be seeing a 0.000 na p-value, ibig sabihin, sobrang liit nun. Okay? Sobrang liit ng p-value mo. Pero hindi ka pwedeng mag-report ng 0.00000 na value. Okay? So normally, yung mga statisticians, nilalagyan niya ng 1 sa dulo. Ibig sabihin, it's very, very low. Okay? So dahil mababa yung p-value natin, meron bang difference? Do we have significant difference or no significant difference? Mababa si p kesa kay alpha. Ang alpha natin, 0.05. Tapos ang p-value natin, sobrang liit, almost 0. Mas mababa si p kesa kay a. Reject or not reject? Reject or fail to reject? We reject. Tandaan ha, pag mas mababa si p, we fail to reject. Ay, sorry, we reject. Ulit po. Pag mas mababa si p kay alpha, we reject the null hypothesis. Ibig sabihin, merong significant difference. Now, the question is, alam ba natin kung bakit nagkaroon ng significant difference? No. Ang alam lang natin is, may difference. Okay? So, that's one, no? Any questions so far?
None, sir.
Ah, sige. Ngayon, tignan naman natin kung may relationship yung pressure ng tuition sa periodical test. Mas mataas ba yung tuition ng isang bata? Mas mataas yung nakukuha niya sa periodical? Okay. Yung tuition tsaka yung periodical test, they are both quantitative. So, Pearson ang ginagamit dyan, right? So, ang ginagamit dyan ay basic stats. You click stat again, then basic stats. You go to correlation. Okay. You click intuition and periodical test. And then the method, as you can see here, is Pearson. Dalawa yan, either Pearson or Spearman. Okay? We will display the p-values. Okay, so as you can see, ang p-value ay 0.8. Anong ibig sabihin yan? Mataas ba sa 0.05 or mas mababa? So basically, we all know it's mababa, ay is mataas. Mas mataas yung p-value sa 0.05. So do we reject or do we fail to reject? Of course, we failed to
reject.
That's correct. We failed to reject. So, ibig sabihin, walang significant relationship. Hindi dahil mataas ang tuition mo, mataas na ang periodical test score mo. Yun yung implication nun. Pero ang tanong, for the question na, I'll stop sharing na. For the question na, alam ba natin yung reason kung bakit wala silang relationship? Hindi. Because the causations for that will be done by another research. Doon pumapasok yung either the qualitative research or the mixed method. Okay? Any questions so far?